Good morning, good morning, good morning. It is December 21, 6 a.m. over there on the East Coast, and I'm going to keep it quick and simple, and I am going to make you laugh and spit coffee everywhere and wish that you were active in the room yesterday with your change in your ashtray, because man, did that one work out. Today, 8:30 in the morning, we get the initial jobless claims, the GDP for the quarter, bullshit number, and we get the U.S. core PCE prices, which, if any of you have seen, General Mills had a horrible earnings report, and the reason being is nobody is buying $3 cereal for $8.85 anymore. Thus, their sales have declined. Makes perfect fucking sense. So, onward and forward. Start out here in the chat. I think I saw a record number of tweets from people I actually follow that were all saying, I called the top. I called the top. You know, we all call the top. We all do. For me, 43.83. Back when we were at 43.83 a month ago, extreme overbought over on the 4 hour, and I said, that's it, this is my top, I'm getting into my March, my June, my December puts for next year, 2024, and 43.83 is, what, 400 points below us? Again, when we got up into that highs, the July highs of 2023 and the all-time highs, and we were hitting that trend line. That's it. Here we go. We're here. We're at the top. And then we got a gap up above that. That was back at, what, 45.85, 45.60 area? 200 points above right now. But I did mention yesterday, and I started mentioning it because you got to adjust according to your climate, you know, and that 47.78, because there, when you're playing with charts and you're playing with real-time indexes and movements, you have to make adjustments. There is no concrete set in stone like with human beings.
Boys have a penis, girls have a vagina.
You gotta make adjustments. And just like the only country in the world that has made adjustments, being the United States, when it comes to the human being factor, we were talking about 47.78, talking about 47.78, talking about 47.78. And then what did we get? 47.78.01. So I went out there and made a digital signature, put it on the chart. I can send it to you. You can print it, make posters, put it up on your wall. You can make toilet paper out of it. You can do whatever you want. But coming in, let's go in here to a zoomed in view. I'll get off the VIX, go on to the SPX, go into a 1 minute and remove the studies just so that we can see this. And literally, as we were in the chat there, and we were talking in, where was it? The alert room. Where are we going back up to yesterday? Right around that point after that 47.78 hit. Right there, 154. So your risk, zero DTE, 47.60 puts or 60 cents. 47.70s, obviously being deeper in the money, they're $2.75. The 47.70s closed at $70.10, while the 47.60s went from the 60 cents right here just before 2 o'clock and closed at 59.60. Now, Nancy sent me a beautiful message, and I asked her if I could share it. She said, yes, but please just don't share my screen name, because I don't want a whole bunch of messages from people about, how did you do this? What did you do there? Because she's been with me for 4 years. She knows that when you get frustrated, when you are expecting a move to come and people start becoming, you know, anxious, when someone has success, everybody goes over there and just inundates them. Imad had it when he was making $100,000 trades. you trade you. That's the way you do it. But again, she took her $400, six contracts. As soon as it moved, because it moved so quick, she took the one off, and it paid for the other four, paid for the other five. And she rode those five all the way to 5960, $29,800 on a $400 trade. So she made a decision that she's going to donate 20,000 of it to the kids, like, you know, our dedication is. And I am not going to hit you in the heart today. I'm not. Today's a day to keep you happy, because, you know, what we had yesterday was specifically a float up into 4778, where we had nothing going on. And then all of a sudden, you got this message that came over in the alert room. And now that you've cleaned up your coffee and, you know, you've cleaned up your mess, then you had the fastest minus 1% decline on the SPX this year. And where did you get to? Well, we will zoom back out to where I started on this and put my everything back on and edit studies and remove the 50-day, because that is just thinking elf on a shelf is going to be, you know, the greatest thing alive. We broke the 5-day moving average. We almost came to the 10-day moving average, and we are nowhere near yet to the FOMC lows. We talked about these FOMC lows weeks ago. They were deleted from everybody's memory because they are so far away. Well, these 50, 50, 52, 53, 45 point major dips that we've had during this run up from the beginning of November, end of October, you just got 80 points, 80 points in 2 hours. The market is still very, very much alive. And just for shits and giggles, I will bring you over here onto Tesla and bring you into a 1-minute chart, remove these studies so that we can get it all there. And like I said, that 258.94 was the trigger. And where is that big fat line? That big fat line is right down there below 246. And God damn it, right down to it. So here we are on QQQ, looking at a wide view of the QQQ and this euphoric move that came after we had, okay, we got it. Here we go. We got it. Break 384 and then kabam. Here we are over on the QQQ with a fractional dip, have not broken 402. We have not tested 399. On the QQQ itself, it is working on a, only had a 1.5% drop on the QQQ, so keep that in mind as well. The QQQ week is 404.93. We are currently, at the moment, bring you into a 1 minute, make sure that we are showing everything here for extended periods, remove these studies so we can see it. And as of this moment, off of that 4 o'clock bounce, closing on the lows yesterday, the QQQ is green on the week.
We tried to reach out to the man who died in this pursuit. They were unavailable for comment. Micah, back to you.
So, not out of the woods, not even close to being out of the woods. IWM, that credit spread that I had on the 201-200s, could have left it, wanted to be responsible, roll it very early in the day, decided to roll it maybe around 1 o'clock, 1:30, and lo and behold, I was right anyway. The trade would have worked out perfectly, but I collected additional credit and I have it until Friday, and I have absolutely no fear that I'm getting a close below 200 come Friday. Zoomed out, wider view is what you've got here, and that is the IWM still has not broken below that 196. 196 is your big major break. Break down below 196 and you can start to assume we have absolutely begun. And I will bring you on to your VIX. The VIX, hala, 1339, 1393 on the highs. However, these ghost plus 14 wicks that we were getting way back in late November, we haven't hit up into that 14 area yet. So yesterday was a dip. Is it a start? Like I shared to you, the full moon window is open. The full moon is not until December 26th. However, the full moon tracking that I have done over the years is plus or minus 3 trading sessions. So being that today is 20, 21, 22, we are closed on 25. 26 is your full moon, 27, 28, 29. That's your window from yesterday, the 20th, until the 29th. That is the full moon window, and we hit this so hard. We hit it so hard. We got to have a Christmas song. See you guys in the chat room.